check?
Yes, ma'am.
Good afternoon, children. How are you
good
all?
Good afternoon.
We are doing good, ma'am.
Okay,
how are
so
you, ma'am?
You know, I'm good. I'm your science teacher. And today, you know, yesterday we have learned about the component of food. Do you remember what did we learn and which are the component of food?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yes, Zareen, can you tell me?
There are five components, ma'am. Fats, carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, and minerals.
So, ma'am is doubtful about our timing.
Very
because,
good.
There will be hindrance with the new blower batch timing.
And Maya, can you mute yourself? Okay, very good, Zareen. So now, Zareen told us there are five components of food which we have learned yesterday. Let's check if you can answer the questions related to it. So I have a small quizzes for you. Let's see. First answer. Seema, are you ready for the first question?
Yes,
can
ma'am.
Can you read and answer the question?
Which one of the following nutrients gives us energy to do work? Ma'am, it's carbohydrates.
Very good. Okay. Now I want Blessy. Blessy, are you ready for the next question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Read the question and answer.
A vitamin required for maintaining good eyesight. It's vitamin C, ma'am.
Is it vitamin C? Please check again for the eyesight. Very good. It's vitamin A. Very good. Okay. Now the next. Rabia, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am. Name the mineral whose deficiency causes goiter. Iodine.
Very good. Excellent. Okay, so you know the component of food very well, right? Children, just now we have celebrated one festival, right? Most of us, we celebrated one festival. Which was that?
Diwali.
Diwali.
Yes, it was Diwali. And what we do specially in Diwali? Bhavika, can you tell us?
Yes, ma'am. We lit candles and diyas.
Okay. Any other thing?
And we burn crackers also.
Okay, that's ma'am. Okay. What about dress?
Yes, ma'am. New dress.
Ma'am, we wear traditional dress.
And yes. Dance, very good. We wear different types of traditional dresses. So, you know that we are wearing beautiful and different variety of clothes, and they are of different styles, like for the different occasion we wear different clothes, right? So children, do you know from where we are getting these clothes, or from which thing we are getting making these clothes?
From cotton, ma'am.
Cotton.
Very good. Yes, very good.
Wool.
Yes,
silk.
Very good.
Silk.
Very good. Do you know our ancestor, what they used to wear when there were no cotton clothes or silk clothes or woolen clothes?
Leather.
Very good. Yes, they were used to wear the leather of the animals and leaves, right? And which were protecting them from the heat and cool. Yes. See,
yes,
you can
ma'am.
See here the man is wearing the skin of animal, and here leaves. Yes. So now, as you know, since the prehistoric, there has been drastic change in the clothing of the people. Yes. They used to wear animal products and plant products directly, but Now, are we using the plant and animal products directly to make the clothes or directly as a clothes?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Slowly, we have changed our style and now not directly we are wearing the leaves or the skin of the animals. So today our topic is how it's fiber and fabric. And now, do you know how do we make clothes from plants and animals?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, anybody can tell me? Seema?
Yeah, ma'am. Cotton, from the cotton plants, we will take cotton. We grow cotton. And that can be sent to looms where and weaving, they'll do the weaving. Then they will send that to the factories.
Very good.
And coloring.
Right.
Dying.
Very good, Seema. Seema knows most of the things, how we make clothes from plants and animals. So now, children, as Seema told us how from the cotton we are making the cotton clothes, but do you know how the clothes or a piece of cloth, like I have this, what is this?
Mask,
right? Ma'am. Is it made up of one single thread?
No, ma'am.
How many threads are there?
How many?
N number, ma'am.
Very good. There are many, but it starts with a single thread of fiber. Now, you will ask me, what is a fiber? Do you know but what is a fiber?
No.
I will tell you. What is a fiber? You will feel that fiber, oh, it's a big word, but you know, it's a simple thing. Fibers are nothing but a long thread. Yes, fiber is nothing but a long thread. Yes. And now we are going to learn there are fibers which are two types. One is natural fibers, in that plant fibers and animal fibers, and man-made fibers. So today we are going to learn about the plant fibers. So do you have any idea which are the plant fibers?
Can I, ma'am?
Yes, Seema.
Jute.
Very good.
Yeah.
Yes. Shishti, can you tell me any other type of plant fiber?
Ma'am, cotton also will be plant fiber.
Yes, very good. Yes, Shishti. Cotton is also a plant fiber. Okay. And there is one more.
And silk. Can we say silk also?
No, silk is,
silk is not a plant fiber. But they eat plant leaves also, leaves, right?
Yes.
So
yes,
we cannot say that they are.
It is from the animal. So caterpillar is like they eat.
Silkworm.
Yes, silkworms, they eat plants, and from that you are getting, they are making the silk threads. Yes?
Okay.
So
ma'am.
Now.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes. So. We are learning about the plant fibers, which are cotton, jute, and flax. Okay. And all the plants have fibers in their body structure, just like cotton. So cotton is the most important industrial crop. And India was the proud inventor of cotton clothing. And since 1800 BC, we are using the cotton clothes. And do you know? Cotton plants needs warm climate and moderate or medium rain. It doesn't need too much rain. It grows in a warm climate and in a medium rain also. And so we plant it in a spring season, and it also need black soil. Yes. So in major cotton producing states in India are, you will see in the map of India, these are the main cotton producing states. the first one, which is the major, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, then Haryana, Punjab, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Karnataka, and others are there. Okay, so now we'll go ahead how to make fabric from the fibers of cotton. So if you will see, this is a fruit of cotton and it's called cotton bolls. This is a flower, and when it bursts, we get cotton from it. Okay, now from cotton fibers we can obtain it from cotton bolls. If you will see why, what is the difference between balls, BOLLS and BALLS? What is the difference between these two words? Why I'm using cotton balls over here, which has O, not A? Do you know?
No, ma'am.
Okay, I will tell you. When it is a raw cotton, which is on the plant, it is called, it has the spelling cotton bolls. But when we are cleaning it and we are making the balls, it is called BALLS, cotton balls. Okay. And when these fibers dry in the sunlight, they become fluffy. So now we are going to make a process. See the process, how to make fabric from the cotton. So first is, anybody can read this? What is the first process?
Ginning.
It's ginning, the process of taking or pulling out seeds from cotton balls. So with manually, with hand also, you can take out it, but it's a long process. So we use the machines to separate the seeds. If you will see, this is a container of cotton balls. We put the cotton balls here. Then seeds are separated over there. Then with the help of brushes, the clean cotton we are getting here. So this type of machines we are using, this is called ginning machines. The next is bales. So here the gin cotton compress tightly to the bundles. And if you will see in the picture, these bundles are approximately 200 kgs. So, you know, when we hold the cotton, it is very light. But when they are compressed tightly, then you will get this type of bales. And now, next process is, it is a process sliver. So from those bales, we are going to take out the sliver. Slivers, what is sliver? It is a straightened comb and it is converted into the rope, long rope. And it is also called sliver. Okay. Now next is, children, did you ever see this one with any of our leader?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Mahatma Gandhi. Yes, Mahatma Gandhi. Yes, he used to spin the cotton to make yarn. So this is the process, which is a handmade spinning, or it's called charkha. So with that, you can spin the cotton and make a yarn to make the cloth. So next procedure is spinning. Okay. Now, next is, again, there is a simple spinning, which is with the use of the handmade wooden instrument. It is called tuckley or hand spindle. But in a big quantity, if you want, then there is a spinning machines like this. Okay, so from ginning, after ginning, which process we have done?
Sliver.
Sliver.
And
spinning yarn.
Yes. And after spinning, it's a time to weave. When we are getting, after spinning, we are getting the thin thread, which is very strong. After that, it's time to weave. So putting it together, there are two ways to put it together, by hand or by machine. When we weave the fabric with the hand, it's called handloom. But when it is done by machine, it is called power looms. Okay, even we can knit and make the fabric. It is called knitting. So everyone understood till here? How from cotton balls we are making the fabric, right? Yes?
Ma'am, I have one doubt, ma'am.
Yes, yes, Sima.
This knitting, we will generally we use it for woolen cloths, right, ma'am?
Even for cotton also, you can knit and you can make.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, these are some examples of cotton clothes like this. Okay, now the next one, which is the plant fiber, which is jute, it is also called golden fiber. And yes, it is a very making fiber, fabric from cotton, it's long process, but then from jute, it's little bit easy and it doesn't have so many things. So jute is the cheapest natural fiber. And the jute plant is also called patsan, and jute is obtained from stem. See, can you see the long stems over here? This is the plant of jute, and these are the stems from where we are getting the fiber of jute. And do you know what they are, what these people are doing?
Soaking, ma'am.
Yes, soaking. It is called retting process. In a retting process, bundles are made to sink in stagnant water of pond to separate the fiber. Here, when the people, they are putting the bundles of jute in the stagnant water, then they can separate the fiber. And you know, which is the world's most producing country? Who produced the jute fiber?
Northeast, right?
It's Northeast. India, yes.
Yes, yes.
And in India, it's a West Bengal.
Yes, state. West Bengal. Northeast.
Yeah, and the second country is Bangladesh. Okay, so see, from jute plants, they are putting it in the water to separate the fiber. It is called retting. And then from the rotten stems, they are making the fibers. So fiber can be extracted by hands, also by machines. Yes? Everybody understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, great. And see, I have one pouch, which is made up of jute fiber. Mm. But you can make carpets, dress, curtains, even bags. And yes, even gunny bags with jute. Understood, everyone? Okay. Now, children, we have seen there were three plant fibers. So we have seen cotton and jute. And now next is flax. So now it is for your home assignment. You have to go research and find out the information about flax plant. You can write a small article, you can collect some pictures and few things which are made up of flax fiber. Okay? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, do you know in UAE, did you ever seen any textile industry in UAE?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am, but, no idea.
You know, UAE textile industry is the second largest industry after oil. In UAE, in Fujairah, if you will go, you will see there is a United Textile, which is a big textile mill in Gulf. Okay, so whenever you will visit Fujairah, try to go there and see. I will send this video of United Textile Mill in your Teams. Okay, so you can see what are the things are happening over there. Okay, now let me see how much you understand. So my first question is, what is meant by fiber? Who can tell me? Yes, Blessy.
It's a long thread, ma'am, where the fabric is made.
Very good. It's a
long.
Fibers are nothing but long threads from which we can make fabric. Yeah, okay. Now let me see, Deepa. The process of separating cotton fibers from the seeds by combing is, what is it called?
I forgot, ma'am.
Okay, anybody can help? Deepa? Eleanor, can you help Deepa?
Combing.
Ginning.
Oh, no.
Ginning.
Ginning.
Ginning. Very good. Very good. It's called ginning. Okay, next question. It is for Maya. Maya, to grow best, cotton requires dash type of rainfall.
Less type of rainfall.
Yes, blank. Less. Moderate. You can say medium, yes, or moderate.
And black soil.
Moderate, yes, and black soil and more sunlight.
Yes, very good. Okay, then Ozina, can you name two fibers which are obtained from plants?
Jute and cotton.
Jute and
cotton. Cotton.
Yes. Okay. Then, Shrishti, which country is the leading producer of jute?
Ma'am, India.
Very good. And my last question, which of these fabrics will you choose to wear in hot and humid conditions? Rama?
Cotton, ma'am.
Very good. It's cotton. Excellent. Okay. Now, I'm going to show you something. What is this?
Wool.
Yeah.
Wool.
Wool and thread.
Yes. And what is this? What is this sari made up?
Silk, ma'am. It's a silk sari.
Silk. So, now, as you know, the plant fibers, right? Now, we are going to learn in the next class, we are going to learn about these fibers, from where we are getting those fibers. Are they plant fibers?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Animal fibers.
No, animal fibers. Wool, yes. We get from sheep, ma'am.
Yes. So in the next class, we are going to learn about the animal fabrics. Okay, so I want all of you to research and find out some exciting facts about the animal fabrics, about wool and silk also. Okay, so see you tomorrow. Bye-bye for now.
Thank you, ma'am.
24 minutes.